Hi, my name is David Huan and I'm a director and principal here at QMetrix. And for this short video clip here today, we're going to actually cover off on the foundational elements of Workday Adaptive Planning. Just to introduce you to the core concepts and the building blocks of the solution. So let's take a look. Now the best way to do that is to actually have a look at the expenses planning sheet. So let's navigate to that. Okay, so I'm going to focus your attention firstly on the top right. And this is our versions or scenarios. So this is a really key concept with Workday Adaptive Planning because, you know, when you're looking at information on the screen or planning into it, you need to know which version or scenario you're planning into or reviewing. So things like actuals is a version. Obviously my budget is a version. Last year's budgets is another version, but obviously your forecasts, your strategic plans, your long range plans, and of course your what if scenarios, they're all different versions. So this is really a key concept with Workday Adaptive Planning. Just below that is another key element. And this is your org structure. So think of it as your profit center or cost center, and how it rolls up into different departments or different divisions. And in this case, rolling up another level into different entities. So as you can see here, this is quite a large organization, These elements here, and this what I'm showing you right now, would be completely customizable to your specific organization. And it essentially follows your responsibility or accountability lines when it relates to budgeting and planning and obviously reviewing the numbers. So right now I'm focusing on the Sales North cost center or profit center. And on the far left is our GL accounts. So these are, again, you know, should start looking familiar to you in terms of your general ledger system when I'm talking about your cost centers, but also your general ledger as well. So again, this would generally reflect your reporting structures. And of course, there is the time period here that you can see across the top. So that's another core element you need to understand when you're doing your plans or reviewing the numbers, what time period am I looking into? So again, this is customizable. I've got this as a by month, which is 95% of the time, but depending on how your organization is set up, it could even be by week. So effectively, they are the four key sort of building blocks to Workday Adaptive Planning. You've got your versions, you've got your org structure, your general ledger accounts, and of course, your time period. Now, I'm going to also highlight as part of this video, just some very basic input options that you have straight out of the box when planning with Workday Adaptive Planning. Now, this doesn't cover off on the more comprehensive Java-based models. That will be covered off in a separate video. But for this one, we're just going to show you some of those very, very basic input options that you have. So first, let's focus on the training account here. Now, I've entered in $1,000 across every single month. But if I wanted to break that down to have a bit more information, I can actually right-click on this line and add what's called a split. So let's add a bit more detail behind it. So there is manager's training, and there will be OH&S training as well. And I can just fill that in. So this really gives your budget contributors some control around the level of detail they want to break down, say, their training expense. An important thing to note, this is against just the Sales North profit center. If I was to navigate away to go to, say, Sales South, they wouldn't see this sort of customized split. So it really is specific to your budget contributor and allows them free rein to add as much detail or as little detail as they would like without breaking anyone else's input templates. Another thing to note, you know, if you wanted to add detail, it doesn't have to be just through splits. You can still leverage the Excel functionality that we do use from time to time. That is basically cell commentary. So I can add a bit of a note here and just say training for 3 new staff members as an example. And that will then highlight, just like Excel, a little a red icon for me to see. Now my changes are in blue, they're not locked away, so I can hit save now just to confirm those. Another really quick and easy method of getting some numbers in is also the ability to key in at the yearly level. So not having to build up the numbers by individual month, I can actually spread and do a top-down spread of any of these particular accounts. So let's say legal and professional, I want to increase that 12,000 at the yearly level to 20,000. When I key that in and press enter, I get prompted with how I want to push that number back. So I can leave it as the default to push that number in proportion to what's there, or I can choose to spread that number back based on last year's seasonality. And of course, there is a few other options that I can choose, but if I've got really specific needs around seasonality, such as trading days, as an example, that changes year on year, I may want to customize my own phasing assumption. But in this example, let's just say I want to spread it back based on last year's values. So I'm going to hit OK and lock that in. And you can see there that for legal and professional now, it's only got values against those months that had values last year, but it's still rolled up to the 20,000 that I entered in. Again, I'm going to hit save to lock that in. And lastly, another really quick inputting option is to pivot my account and cost centers around. So let's say I want to make wholescale changes across various departments and cost centers for a particular GL account, say telephone. I can right click on the telephone account and select view by level. So now what this has done is it's moved the telephone account now to the top right, and I now have my org structure down the left hand side. So if I wanted to make a change, let's say from July onwards for United States and Canada for their telephone and give it a bit of an uplift in cost, I can right click that, adjust, and let's apply a 10% increase. So very quickly and easily, I've just done a 10% uplift from July onwards for those two different, those two locations. So let's hit save and lock that in. And now I can pivot back to Sales North. So that's all I wanted to showcase for today's short video clip. It doesn't cover off on the detailed driver-based planning, and that will be in future videos, but it was really just an introduction to the foundational elements of Workday Adaptive Planning. I hope you got a lot out of it, and if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out.